Okay, I'm back with updates, and letting you guys know exactly where I'm at with this car. Although I haven't posted nothing in about 2 weeks, I have lots of really cool videos shot already. Just need editing, and I got some cool things that I think you guys are gonna love to see. So let me show you all where I'm at with this right now, what's going on with this. Today is the steering wheel selection. I pretty much know what I'm gonna use in this application because the goal for this is originality, to try to be original as possible, although I've added some touches to it. Okay, I'm talking about, oh, look at that, that looks beautiful. Look at that. Look how that hit off. When I clean this up, that's gonna look nice. And the door, well, this side is pretty much done. I got stuff over there in the way, so I can't get over there yet to finish it off. I'm also installed this center console piece for the gear selector. That turned out really nice. I'm about to install this one right now. Just have to find the right size rivets for this. Just found some. This is the exact size that was in here. And this turned out nice, so I'll use my rivet gun and I'll pop them in place and finish that off, and I'll install that. But yeah, that looks really nice. And everything's coming together. I haven't been back there, haven't touched the back yet. So I'm gonna do that. But today's video is strictly about the steering wheel selection. Also, tomorrow I'll be installing the windshield, so that video is coming tomorrow. So be looking out for that video within the next few days as well. But steering wheel selection is today's video. We're gonna see how all of them look. Although I've got my mind made up, we're gonna see. These are all in really, really, really nice condition. All these are steering wheels on. This is new, of course. Bought this because I like the cockpit feel. I'm 5'11", and I knew if somebody was maybe in their over 6 feet, 6'4", like I got a couple friends that's 6'5", 6'6", they can drive possibly using this steering wheel without hitting their knees, or without hitting their legs on the steering wheel and having some room. That's what my initial thought or goal was for using this one. If you look at the difference, I didn't know it was that much off. I thought this was just a little bit smaller than it, but it's actually a nice size, and we're gonna measure that and I'll show you all what I'm talking about. If you guys look. Look at this. About 13 inches. And this one is right around 15 inches. So in diameter, that's pretty significant in diameter wise. And of course this one probably, yeah, on the lines of this one. So let's put all of them in and we'll see what we get. Let's look, take a look at each one of them installed in the car. I'll just put them in. Okay, we're gonna mount the camera, but I do wanna know, all these are stainless screws. All the screws are installed in the hardware, even in here and here, they're all stainless screws. Just to try to add some longevity to the hardware. Post it rusting out. Let's mount the camera and take a look. Each one of them look. So I'll set them inside. We'll get a feel for them. We'll just set this one in here. That's nice. Looks good. Original. Not bad. Looks nice. If I clean it up, I have to clean it. Clean this up and shine it up. It'll look nice. Not bad. Classic Mustang look. Look good. Everything looking copacetic. Nice. Not bad. All right. Oh, let me mention something too before. Now, these are the door bumpers. They go here. So I'm going to put those on. And go here, so. Cool. I think they make contact with this part, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, these are the door bumpers. I'm going to put those on. Not bad, not bad, not bad. All right, let's go to the next one. That looks good too. Maybe I should have got that chrome piece that covers that. But we're just sitting in here to kind of get a feel for it. The cockpit feel. Smaller steering wheel, more leg space from the seat. And the seat is all the way back too. I believe so. Yep, the seat is all the way back. Got that distance between here. I'm gonna measure that real quick too. Let's see. Let's see how far it is from the seat. Of course, the seat presses in some. Once you sit on it, it'll sink in some. But 6 inches. It's approximately 6 inches from the seat. And of course, if it sinks in about half an inch or an inch, with weight on it, that adds more distance between the seat and the steering wheel. But nice cockpit feel with that one. Looks good. However, the only thing throws me off from this one a little bit is that it has chrome. It has chrome here on the spokes of this steering wheel. And although you have some chrome there, chrome accent handles, a little chrome there, a little touch of chrome here and there. It's mostly the stainless look throughout here with the door panels, the dashboard. But still don't look bad. It would work if I wanted to go this route. It'll work. The cockpit feel. I like that. I like that. I really like that. All right, so let's try the other one. Yeah, it has a chrome base. I have it still in the box, brand new. So, should move this. Okay, let's try the last one and see. Probably gonna be the look. And a couple things here. It sits out, so it does allow some leg space. So it's not that big of a difference because how it sits out. It's actually a look. It's about the same. So that being smaller doesn't affect how the distance from the seat. It just, it's back some. So it's not as forward as that one. But that's nice. The spokes on the steering wheel kind of goes with the concept of everything a little bit better than the chrome. This is an original steering wheel. Although it's not the leather wrap one, which would be nice to have, but I think they only came in King Cobras. I'm not sure. But this does a couple things for me. It keeps my goal for this car, which is originality, to keep it as original as possible. And it goes with that theme, my originality theme. So this is probably going to be the winner here. I'm going to go with that look to keep that vintage feel throughout the vehicle, the concept of the car. And yeah, I'm going to do that. I'm just going to probably go with that one. Yeah, I am going to go with that one. Just to kind of give complete, just kind of put the icing on the cake for my interior. So I'm going to pop that piece on in a second. But yeah, that's it. I'm going to just stick with this and try to keep it as original as possible. And it does look good. It kind of hits off with everything else I got going on. And I really like it. So just want to show you all this. I do want to say this final thing before I close out. I'm starting not to look at this car as if it's a car. Some weird feeling as I move along with this particular vehicle. And even the vehicles that I got coming forth on the channel, when I go into depth of kind of taking them apart and putting them back together like so, I'm kind of looking at it as if it's art to me. I mean, like, everything doesn't have to be perfect. It's going to look perfect. It's going to be perfect. But every single thing doesn't have to be flawless. And so far, everything is near perfect here. But I don't have to fix everything. That's what I'm looking at this as. I'm getting like an artist, probably what an artist feel when they're doing art. Everything doesn't have to be perfect. And what I mean by is just this. As bad as I want this little piece here to be perfect, it doesn't have to be. It kind of shows that the age of the vehicle. So it's been having this weird feeling about that. Just kind of, that's how I've been approaching this particular car. And I'm enjoying it. I realized that I can't make everything perfect, and I'm fine with that. I'm accepting it. It's just fun putting everything back together and making everything look really nice. But I've kind of turned, although these seats are near perfect, I'm okay with this little piece here. I'm okay with that small piece of vinyl missing from that button, because it does show age. So hopefully you guys are understanding what I'm saying. That's like a weird feeling that I've been getting as I started to dig down and finish this car. It's becoming a piece of art. I don't look at it as a Ford Mustang. I look at it as like it's art, like I'm painting on a canvas. Just weird. And that's how it's been coming together to me. I really feel that way. And it's probably going to be like that with every other project, a different car. I'm not going to look at it as if it's a car. But moving forward, every vehicle you guys have seen on the channel, when I go into this detail with it, a vast detail like I've done with this car, I'm going to approach it as if it's art. Everything doesn't have to be perfect. Like this steering wheel, it shows some wear, which is fine. This car is 50 years old almost. So I'm fine with that. I've covered all the areas that I wanted to cover to make it look really nice and to drive amazing. I think that was the goal for me. So that's where I'm at. Next video, windshield will be installed. Tomorrow I'll be installing that. And then I can approach the body. I got something really, really, really awesome I bought. It's kind of over here in a massive box. Let's see if I can give you guys a sneak peek of it. It's in this massive, massive box. I bought that, and be on the lookout for that on our channel. Probably next week or so. And I got a lot of videos of the other Mustang recorded and some more things, but you all gonna love that video, I promise, because I'm kind of taking things a step up. And I got a secret, I got a surprise Look, pay attention to the thumbnails. I'm gonna shock you all with something that I did, and I kind of left it out. I did this some months back. I bought something some months back, maybe 5 months ago, 4 months ago, and I wasn't gonna share it with y'all, but I want you all to see what happened. Now I want to share it with you all, so pay attention. Look for the thumbnail. It's so revolving around the Mustang tubes. So pay attention for this weird thumbnail to pop up. I think you guys are gonna enjoy that video as well. So I hope you all are enjoying this project and the other things I'm posting. Once again, thank you for watching. Terrence, I'm out.